I'm Susan Schreibman, and I'm one of the co-developers of the Text Encoding and TI module, and I'm going to talk about document type definitions, or DTDs. So DTDs create a document structure. They create them as tree structures, and these are not dissimilar to other structures that you've encountered before. For example, they're similar to templates and word processing programs. DTDs are not written in XML syntax as schemas are, but they're written in a syntax called Extended Backus Noir Format, which is a formal language or notation for tersely and precisely describing the rules of a language. So there are a formal set of rules which define document structure. They dictate what and where elements and attributes can be used. And by defining the document structure, the DTDs specify document hierarchy and granularity. DTDs can be external or internal. If they're internal, they appear at the top of the document. Internal DTDs are tidy, they're self-contained because you have the DTD and then the document that uses that structure below it. But if you're using one DTD with many documents, they're not so useful. The internal ones and external ones are better. And that's because each time you make a change to the DTD, you have to make the change in each and every document that uses it. So if you have 20 documents, each with their own DTD at the top, you've got to change it 20 times. External DTDs, on the other hand, allow one set of rules to be applied to many documents. And these have a lot of advantages. It facilitates consistency in encoding across documents. Easy to make changes to one DTD, and then every time a document instance calls that DTD, it recognizes the changes that have been made. A document instance is the external content file that refers to a particular DTD. The way computers check DTDs for correctness is by parsing the document instance or the encoded file. If you're using a parsing editor, that editor reads the set of rules, reads the DTD or schema, and each time you make a change in your document instance, open an XML tag, it will read the DTD and indicate to you that this is where you can put this element or this kind of attribute, as you see on this slide. Today, most people use schemas rather than DTDs. They're more powerful, they're written in XML syntax, they allow for data typing, and they also allow more than one schema to be applied to a document instance. This is called using namespaces, and it allows even elements that have the same name to be processed differently. So here's a little snippet of the TEI DTD. So here you see I'm creating an element called TI2. And it has two children elements, TI header and text. In the middle box, I am creating my element called TEI header. And in it, I am indicating that I have four sub-elements. These are sibling children elements, file description, encoding description, profile description, and revision description. And you see those symbols after some of them, the asterisks or the question mark, and those are what's called occurrence indicators. And they indicate when and how many times and if an element can or must be used. And in the third, the last box, I have the element file description being called or created, and the children element you could see from title statement to source description. So here you can see that inheritance comes from the DTD and not the document instance. So TI header and text are children of TI2. TI2 is the parent, and TI header and text are sibling elements. So why would you use a DTD or a schema? They're an important and powerful part of XML. They enforce syntax uniformity. They ensure elements and attributes are used properly. They help to separate document structure from content in the document instance. They allow smoother styling and transformation of data using CSS or XSL. They're a formal description of data via the DTD. and this allows for uniform changes, our modifications. And it is possible in XML, unlike HTML, to have a document without a DTD attached to that. And that was that well-formed XML document. And on this last slide, this is just an example of a DTD for articles, and I will leave you with that.